Good morning. It is Sunday, March 20th. There's a look at the Bay Bridge there in San Francisco, looking a little bright, but it is a beautiful Sunday morning. And thank you for joining us. I'm Cierra Johnson, in for Kira Clapper. Meteorologist VNA Arana is with us this morning to take a look at your microclimate forecast. Good morning.
Good morning. That system moved in so fast, right? Just as quickly as it moved in, it has now cleared out, and your Sunday ahead is going to be spectacular. Look at satellite radar right now. You can see we're no longer seeing that green over the region. It's now to our east, and you might spot some cloud cover early on, but don't worry, that's going to clear out by the afternoon. We're starting a little chilly in the 40s right now in San Jose. It's about 46 degrees, but by 1 o'clock, we're going to bump up into the 60s, and that's sort of where we're going to sit at today, in the mid 60s. It is going to get breezy though, but it'll remain dry. And yes, today we are getting ready to welcome the first official day of spring. That begins at 8:33, and then we set ahead into a warming trend into the work week. I'm going to guide you through all of this coming up in my full forecast, Sierra.
Sounds good. Thank you. Well, now to the latest out of Ukraine. Residents there waking up to another day of violence and uncertainty. Here's a live look at Lviv. Ukraine continues to resist 25 days into invasion. Our NBC News crews there say once again, air raid sirens sounded throughout the night. Meantime, the city council of Mariupol, which has been battered by heavy shelling and attacks, alleged that several thousand residents have been deported to Russia over the past week. This, as we're learning, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky says he's heavily invested in ongoing peace talks with Moscow. He says there's the possibility Ukraine could emerge as a country with no particular alliance to Russia or the U.S. backed into a military alliance. And all of this comes as Russia confirmed it has launched a hypersonic missile. Experts believe this is now part of Russia's strategy that will only worsen the growing humanitarian crisis. Today in the base, Stephanie Magoln continues our coverage.
A strategy of attrition. That's what experts are calling this explosion caused by Russia's hypersonic missile, a weapon with the ability to fly 10 times the speed of sound and is extremely hard to shoot down. UK's defense ministry says Russia's plan is likely to increase civilian casualties, the destruction of Ukrainian infrastructure, and intensify the humanitarian crisis.
This is a turning point for the world.
British Prime Minister Boris Johnson, today at a Conservative Party conference, made it clear that a win for Russia is a win for oppression and a loss for freedom.
The end of freedom in Ukraine will mean the extinction of any hope of freedom in Georgia and then Moldova. It will mean the beginning of a new age of intimidation across the whole of Eastern Europe, from the Baltic to the Black Sea.
Since the start of the invasion, the UN says at least 64 Ukrainian children have been killed, hundreds more injured, and 1.5 million children have been forced to flee.
Mariupol is hell on earth.
Stanislav and his wife just escaped Mariupol, where leaders claim Russian soldiers have forced thousands to relocate in Russia. Today, more than 4,000 people were able to leave Mariupol thanks to newly negotiated humanitarian corridors. Meanwhile, President Zelensky is asking for peace talks. Stephanie Magallon, NBC Bay Area News.
This morning, we are also learning that one volunteer overseas has been taken captive in Ukraine. The woman has only been identified by her first name, Valentina. According to the Christian Broadcasting Network, which is based in Virginia, Valentina was kidnapped on Thursday near Mariupol. She had been working for Orphans Promise, a humanitarian outreach of CBN. Witnesses say kidnappers, likely Russian soldiers, put a bag over her head and took her away.
Valentina was one of our missionaries. Long-term volunteers that has worked with us since the beginning of war, 2014. And she actually is a lady in her early 60s, very devoted, just really, truly had a heart to help people.
At the time of the kidnapping, CBN says Valentina was helping distribute food to people hiding in bomb shelters. And making it in the Bay still difficult amid high gas prices. And unfortunately, they're still climbing. Take a look. Today, the average for a gallon of regular gas in California is $5.84. That's just 1 cent up from yesterday and 10 cents from last week. And we want to help you find the cheapest gas. Just go to NBCBayArea.com and click on the link that says cheapest gas in the Bay Area at the top of our homepage. You can also search cheapest gas on our NBC Bay Area app. A tentative deal has been reached between the Mount Diablo Unified School District and teachers. Earlier this week, the teachers' union voted to authorize the strike. Many of them hit the picket lines Friday, but early Saturday morning, the two sides reached a deal. The agreement has scheduled salary increases amounting to 10.5% raise over the next 3 years. While teachers won't get more prep time, they will get the same amount of time they currently have. The union will now have to confirm the agreement. And moving you forward this morning, starting tomorrow, students within the Oakland Unified School District will now be able to ditch the mask in indoor settings. The new mask guidance applies to all students, staff, volunteer, and visitors. Masks indoors are still required. That guidance will be reviewed again after April 15th. And also in Oakland, police are investigating a sideshow that ended in a deadly shooting. It happened just before 3 a.m. on Saturday near 42nd Avenue and 880. Now, this is a video from the scene from Snapchat. Police initially got a call about a man lying in the road who'd been hit by a car. When officers arrived, 500 to 600 cars were blocking the roads. When officers got to that man, they discovered he had also been shot. He died at the hospital. Two men were also shot in unrelated shootings at the sideshow. Those victims drove themselves to the hospital. It was an emotional night as family and friends gathered to remember 8-year-old Sophia Mason. The little girl from Hayward was reported missing and later found dead at a home in Merced. As Today in the Bay's Marianne Favre reports, her family and the community tonight are hoping to help them heal.
Tonight, the focus was not just on remembering Sophia, but making important changes in the future to better protect children.
Her family says Sophia Mason was a bright, vibrant 8-year-old who loved dancing. They called her So-So.
A sweet, wonderful girl. Like, as my sister said, you would never have known outside of this situation if you had met her on the street that she was going through all that she had. She was so wonderful and so happy and full of joy and promise.
Heavy hearts in Hayward as people gathered to remember the 8-year-old who was found dead in a Merced home. Sophia's mother, Samantha Johnson, is accused of murder, and police are still searching for her boyfriend, Dante Jackson. Tonight, Sophia's young classmates struggling to understand why they can't play with their friend anymore.
She always brings joy, and she always was smiling and happy. I just wish I could see her again.
Sophia's family say they reported warning signs of abuse to police and Child Protective Services. Police confirm they receive reports of possible abuse, but state agents decided to leave Sophia with her mother.
Sophia was saying that mommy and Dante are hitting me, they're beating me with belt buckles. There were bruises between her legs.
Now Sophia's family is joining forces with the community to make sure other children will be better protected.
We're also here to elevate her case, elevate what happened to her, so that we can make sure that in the future that adults and systems respond to kids' cry for help.
A family shedding tears for their loss, vowing that Sophia's short life will be a catalyst for change. In Hayward, Marianne Favre, NBC Bay Area News.
Today, family members of Alexis Gabe, the missing Oakley woman who was last seen in January, will hold a vigil in her remembrance. This comes as the search for Alexis continued over the weekend. Yesterday, family and volunteers gathered at the streets of Brentwood Mall. Her car was found abandoned in Oakley with the keys still in the ignition. The search came just 3 days after Gabe turned 24. Anyone interested in attending are asked to arrive at the Antioch Oakley Regional Shoreline Park. The vigil will get underway at 6 p.m. And new overnight, 4 people are recovering after being shot and wounded in downtown Austin, Texas. Early this morning, the shooting unfolded as the city was hosting the first in-person South by Southwest festival in 3 years. It took place as thousands were still out and about in the entertainment district. All 4 victims were rushed to the hospital and are expected to be okay. According to Austin Travis County EMS, the suspect is in custody. Asking for forgiveness coming up on Today in the Bay.
And I am sorry if I have embarrassed you in any way.
Antioch Mayor Lamar Thorpe is apologizing after he was pulled over and cited for driving under the influence. Why he says this will be a learning experience. And we take you live to Washington, D.C. for our weekly interview with Chuck Todd for a preview of this week's Meet the Press.
Time and temperature on NBC Bay Area is brought to you by Mancini Sleep World, simply the best place to buy a mattress.
Receive three free gifts with a qualifying mattress purchase now at Mancini Sleep World.
When you buy a brand new car, it loses roughly 50% of its value in the first 3 years. Not the case when you buy a great used car with Shift. Of course, if you really want to waste a bunch of money on a brand new car, you can just do this. Technically, that's littering, so I'm going to go back and pick all that up.
Don't miss out. Shop sale cars at Shift.com. Shift. Used cars never felt so new.
At Tough Shed, we've spent the last 40 years testing the strength and durability of our buildings in some pretty unique ways. And we're still hard at work making sure that our buildings are built to last. Just see for yourself. Is it ready?
It's ready.
Experience the Tough Shed difference for yourself at toughshed.com.
Fresh out of Papa Murphy's kitchen, the Buffalo Ranch Chicken Pizza.
Actually, it's fresh out of my oven.
Dad, it's just an expression.
Grilled chicken, crunchy bacon, covered in creamy buffalo sauce. Now that is an expression.
Change the way you pizza.
From rainbow puddles to the top of the mountain, to wherever we can play together, Northern California families count on Honda. And no matter what adventure awaits, the Honda CR-V will get you there safely and in style. Right now, get a family-friendly deal and up to 40 mpg on a new Honda CR-V. Honda is family. Ask anyone who owns a Honda.
Welcome back. It is now time for our weekly discussion with Chuck Todd, NBC News political director and the moderator of Meet the Press. Hi, Chuck, and thank you for joining us this morning.
How you doing, Sierra?
Well, many developments overseas this morning, including President Biden's trip to Europe. What can we expect to see from this trip, and what type of message will he send not only to our allies, but also Putin as well as Russia?
Well, part of this, I think, is to get the NATO leaders together to make sure they're on the same page, to make sure, you know, are there going to be some red lines that NATO, whether they publicly state them or not, that they're going to agree to? For instance, what is NATO going to do if chemical weapons are used? What is NATO going to do if these missile attacks from Russia continues to target civilians purposely? It's pretty clear he's doing that. So I do think the NATO leaders have to get into some contingency plans on that. Then there is the peace talks. There's probably going to be a moment where President Zelensky addresses those leaders. Is that public or private? My guess it's private, but his asks are also going to be debated. I do think this is going to be that kind of week, though, for these NATO leaders, which is they got to prepare for some contingencies because it's clear the Russians are sort of regrouping their military strategy here. They're using more missile attacks, trying to target civilians, trying to wear down the morale of the Ukrainians. But they don't appear to be ready to try to take siege on Kyiv, which may mean their ambition may have shifted a little bit, where they want to just keep the gains they think they've made and then maybe try to negotiate a ceasefire from there. So I think that's what this NATO meeting is going to be about, which is preparing for those contingencies.
And all eyes will be on those talks. Switching gears a bit, later this morning, you're also sitting down with Republican Congresswoman Liz Cheney of Wyoming, not only to talk about Ukraine, but also the investigation of that January 6th insurrection. Can you give our viewers an update on where that committee investigation stands?
Well, it's interesting. I asked her to do that for us. She made a fascinating comment at the end, and I don't want to mangle it too much. I want viewers to listen to it for himself, but she essentially said there's not been any new piece of evidence that has essentially made Donald Trump's actions look better, right? And every new piece of evidence she's seen has essentially made his actions look worse, which is, I thought, a fascinating statement by her. She also said something else. She said, look, most of what this committee is doing is fact-finding and making recommendations. And one of the recommendations she wants to make is to criminalize and to strengthen the criminal statute that would make President Trump's decision not to intervene and get and even make a statement to get these folks to leave, that that would have been a crime. It is not considered a crime now, but she talked about passing, perhaps recommending that they do criminalize inactivity when it comes to something like that in the moment President Trump, when he decided not to do anything about that riot for a couple of hours.
All right. Well, thank you. An interview we will definitely want to see. Thank you again for joining us, Chuck. And be sure to join Chuck for this morning's Meet the Press. Joining him live will be Senator Chris Murphy, NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg, and Representative Liz Cheney. Tune in to Meet the Press at 8 a.m. right after this newscast. And coming up in about 30 minutes from now, we will talk to NBC Bay Area political analyst Larry Gersten for our weekly segment. Ahead, he breaks down how the American people are feeling towards the president's response to the Russian invasion of Ukraine. And turning now to a major change for local animal shelters. Valley Humane Society in Pleasanton is raising awareness about declining adoption rates. Today in the Bay's Christy Smith explains the negative impacts this may have to animal care.
During the pandemic, people adopted pets and volunteers did their part to help.
We couldn't keep them in stock, so to speak.
Melanie Sadek is president of Valley Humane Society and has watched things change dramatically.
We know that this mass return of adopted animals during the pandemic is not, in fact, happening.
That's welcome news, but she says recently there's been a shift. They're running out of adopters for cats and dogs.
Our interest in having puppies and young animals hasn't changed. It's just that maybe we were too good at telling people that rescues and shelters didn't have them. And so people then went to the internet. And the internet is a problem because people are buying from puppy mills.
Now she says animals are waiting longer for a home.
We're actually seeing fewer animals entering our state shelters, which is amazing. We want that, but when they do enter, dogs are staying 63% longer than normal. At Valley Humane Society, our average length of stay for a dog before the pandemic was anywhere from 6 to 9 days. Now we are seeing even puppies stay 20 to 60 days.
There is concern as animals wait.
If our rooms are full, then we can't go to the public shelter and pull more of those animals out.
She says there are ways to support.
We need our community to adopt, whether it's adopt an animal or adopt a shelter or a rescue and promote their animals.
Christy Smith, NBC Bay Area News.
And it is 7:17, taking a live look outside at the Bay Bridge. Just a beautiful day. You can see that sun kind of creeping up there over that bridge. But what can we expect moving forward? Meteorologist Vianne Arana is here and has a full breakdown. Good morning, Vianne.
Good morning. It's sunny, beautiful day to go out and adopt a new furry friend. Binks is a rescue, so he wants you to go to the shelter and adopt all his friends. Rescue, adopt, don't shop, right? That's the logo. Now let's talk about your weather, because it is going to be a stunning day today. See, by the way, thanks for joining us on a Sunday morning, Sierra. It's nice to have you here. And it is going to be really nice, but it's also going to be a little chilly to start. So it's going to be breezy at times, and I'm going to take you through the timing of the winds. Warming ahead, here's a closer look at what I'm going to take you through during this forecast. And then heading into the middle of the week, 15 to 25 degrees above average as we inch closer in towards the start of Monday, Tuesday, and into Wednesday. Satellite radar right now, though, if you notice, the rain is out of the area just as quickly as that system moved in. It is now exited to our east, and our current temperatures right now, pretty cold in Concord. It was a colder system, so what's being left behind now is going to be breezy winds and chilly daytime highs to start. 39 degrees in Concord right now, Morgan Hill 43, and look at the temperature difference. So we're running about 11 degrees colder right now compared to the past 24 hours at the same time. In through Livermore, about 11 degrees colder, and as far as your hourly temperatures go, by 10 a.m. we're going to bump up into those 50s down through the South Bay, 50 degrees for San Jose, 54 for San Francisco, pushing you forward to about 12 o'clock, 59 in San Jose. And then by the afternoon, we will top out in the mid-60s comfortably in through Fremont, 64, San Francisco, 61. Now, another thing we're going to keep a close eye on are the winds, because if you notice by 4 or 5 o'clock, we start to see the winds pick up 10, 15, 20 plus miles per hour at times. Down through the South Bay, the East Bay as well, similar conditions, 15 to 20 mile per hour winds at times. It does start to increase later later into the day around 4 or 5 o'clock, and then it calms down heading into Monday. But at 8:33, we get ready to welcome the first official day of spring, and I want to take you through what the vernal equinox means. This is at 8:33 in the morning. It's when the Earth is perpendicular to the sun's rays on spring equinox. The 23.5 tilts of the Earth is actually what creates our seasons, as Earth revolves around the sun, and that means daylight increases as the sun sets later. So when you look outside at around 5 o'clock, it's not going to feel like it's 9 p.m. Now, as far as the countdown to the warm-up goes, we get this high pressure that really starts to rebuild much warmer Monday into Wednesday, and then that rain stays to our north. So this blocks any sort of a rain chances heading into the start of the week. And let's take a look at your 7-day forecast, because it is going to be a beautiful day. My graphics are not cooperating, but I will tell you that it is going to warm up quite beautifully. That's going to set us up for a trend into the 70s and 80s as we head in towards Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, Sierra. It's going to feel more like summer than it is spring. So it'll be interesting to see how folks adjust to, you know, this weather whiplash that we've been talking about since earlier this week, Sierra.
I will take the summer weather, though.
I agree. Me too. I'm a fan.
Don't mind a little whiplash. Thank you. Well, there is much more ahead on today in the Bay, including an update on when James Wiseman will be back on the court at the Chase Center, plus NBC Bay Area responds.
You should wash your car before your next road trip for safety reasons. I'm consumer investigator Chris Kimura. I'll explain why next. NBC Bay Area Respond.
Y Telemundo 48 responde.
We respond to every call and every email to help you get your money back.
También respondemos sus dudas como consumidor y le ayudamos a encontrar recursos que necesita.
No question is too small. Contact us anytime.
En inglés o en español.
And check out my how-to videos so you can learn from other people's questions. NBC Bay Area responds.
Y Telemundo 48 responde.
We find solutions that move you forward.
This bus moves you in more ways than one. They can take you from point A to point B and even open doors to opportunities you didn't know existed. So are you willing to get on board and start your journey? At VTA, we're looking for honest, hardworking individuals to join our team. As a VTA bus operator, we offer a competitive salary, excellent benefits, pension, and opportunities to grow your career. Because at VTA, going from point A to point B is really all up to you.
Big news. Powerball now draws 3 days a week, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays.
A Ford built for you, by you. Get yours, built from the ground up with your choice of colors, wheels, and other available features specifically designed for your Ford. Want a head-up display and escape? 7 GOAT modes in Bronco Sport? Or best in its class gas torque and Ranger? You got it. And now an extra $1,000 bonus cash on top of all public offers. See your dealer for a Ford built for you, by you. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus $1,000 retail order open bonus cash on Escape or Explorer.
It's that time of year. Spring and break and summer vacation planning have arrived. Consumer investigator Chris Kimura wants to make sure your car is ready to go. Here's how a penny and a car wash will help.
AAA's research shows more than half of families take a road trip each year. That's millions of us. Well, let's make sure yours is safe with the help of a car wash and President Abraham Lincoln. First, check your tires. This is where we'll rely on Honest Abe.
We're going to follow instructions from the Bridgestone website. Take the penny, Honest Abe side up, then rotate him upside down. Now, take the penny and dip it into the tread of each of your tires. If Mr. Lincoln's head disappears, your tires are good. But if you can see much of his head, the tread is worn, and it might be time to replace your tires.
You'll also want to inspect your battery, your oil, other fluids, belts, and lights. The good news is a lot of auto shops will do general inspections free. If they do any work for you, though, make sure you get a written estimate first. Next, the car wash for safety. Yes, safety reasons. Modern cars have sensors and cameras galore. They power things like lane departure warnings and collision alerts. When pollen or dirt covers those sensors, they can't see the road and can't help you. So wash the car. If you want to see where your car's cameras and sensors are located, check the owner's manual.
Some good advice there. Well, turning to sports now, playing for a trip to the Sweet 16, a lot on the line for St. Mary's last night. The Gaels taking on UCLA in the second round of the tournament. St. Mary's game out shooting, hitting threes, and jumping out for an early lead, but after a hot start, they went cold. UCLA ran away with it 72-56. In another tense game for Gonzaga fans, they took on Memphis in the second round. We pick it up at about 30 seconds left in the game. Memphis gets the clutch, the three-pointer in clutch. They're down two, but Gonzaga hit their free throws and advance to their seventh consecutive Sweet 16. And more unfortunate news for Warriors fans. James Wiseman's return has been delayed again after he experienced swelling in his right knee. He's been playing and rehabbing with the Warriors G League team and was expected to return this week. But now the Warriors are uncertain if he'll play at all this season. They have just 12 more games before playoffs begin. And he's only been a Giant for a few days, but Jock Peterson is already recruiting for the Orange and Black. He posted on his Instagram story in an effort to recruit free agent infielder Trevor Story. It's a video of a story hitting of Story rather hitting a home run for the Rockies. Below it, the words, "Come to the Bay, let's win a World Series." The Giants are reportedly in the mix for Story, a shortstop, but it would require a position change since Brandon Crawford is at shortstop. Much more ahead on Today in the Bay, including the unique way one Harvard student is stepping up and using his talent to help assist refugees who are looking for shelter. And here's a live look at Oakland. It's shaping up to be a great Sunday morning. How's your work week forecast shaping up? Meteorologist Vianne Arana will have a full breakdown when we come back. Stay with us. You're watching Today in the Bay.
BMW iX is electricity in its ultimate form. An elegant trailblazer that's equal parts power and intelligence. With impeccable interior details, a range of up to 324 miles, and a panoramic moonroof for every shade of luxury. It's 100% electric and 100% BMW. BMW, the ultimate electric driving machine. Build your own first ever all-electric BMW iX today.
Jewelry, the perfect gift. While many jewelers are short on stock, the Jewelry Exchange makes their own and has everything. Diamond bands, just $149. 1 carat hoops, $5.99. Tennis bracelets, $4.99. And 1 carat studs, $5.99. Buy factory direct and save. The Jewelry Exchange, Redwood City.
In New York City, there's always something new to discover. Come be a part of it. Plan your next vacation at ilovenewyork.com.
It's big. S&G Carpet Big. S&G features Northern California's biggest selection of flooring with free samples that you can check out and a no-surprise guarantee, so the price they quote is always the price you pay. And during S&G's Flooring Madness Sale, half the store is up to 30% off, including Karastan. Half the store is up to 30% off, even Karastan? Now that's big.
S&G, more than carpet.
Go to sgcarpet.com for the showroom nearest you or to have their mobile showroom come to you.
Is it cool to go to McDonald's just for a drink? Most definitely. Get a medium frappe for $3 or medium iced coffee for $2.
Good morning. It is Sunday, March 20th, and we have a live look there at downtown San Jose. I'm sure it is going to be a beautiful day. That sun there creeping up behind those buildings. I want to thank you for joining us. I'm Cierra Johnson in for Kira Klaffa. Vianne Arana joins us with a quick look at your microclimate forecast. Should be a good one.
It is. You know, the rain has cleared out and it is going to be the first official day of spring at 8:33 in the morning. So we're just a couple of minutes away from that. And here's a live look right now at the Bay Bridge span. And look how beautiful it is out there. I want to show you satellite radar because remember yesterday we had a lot of green on the map. That was all that rain that has now moved out of the area. And as we work to clear out, we are a little bit colder to start because it was a colder system. So we've got some radiational cooling. Temperatures right now in the low 40s. In San Jose, it's about 45 degrees. Dublin 39, Concord 39. And just to give you an idea of how much colder we're running right now, the 24-hour temperature change in areas like Concord and Livermore is about 11 degrees. Here's a closer look at what I'm going to guide you through in my full forecast. Breezy and dry today. Again, spring officially begins at 8:33 a.m. And then, yes, warming ahead as we head into the work week. I'm going to take you through all that in just a few minutes. Let's check in with Sierra.
All right, sounds good. Well, now to the latest out of Ukraine. Residents there are waking up to another day of violence and uncertainty. Here's a live look at Lviv. New this morning, we are learning that President Zelensky has extended martial law for an extra 30 days. Meantime, the city council of Mariupol, which has been battered by heavy shelling and attacks, alleged that several thousand residents have been deported to Russia over the past week. This, as we're learning, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky says he's heavily invested on the ongoing talks, peace talks with Moscow. He says there's a possibility Ukraine could emerge as a country with no particular alliance to Russia or the U.S.-backed NATO military alliance. And meantime, Russia has turned to a strategy of attrition. Defense experts say Russia's indiscriminate use of firepower will cause more civilian deaths and worsen that humanitarian crisis. On Saturday, Russia confirmed the launch of a hypersonic missile to destroy a warehouse filled with ammunition right outside of the city of Kyiv. This weapon has the ability to fly 10 times the speed of sound and are extremely difficult to stop. At a Conservative Party conference, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson made it clear that this war is a turning point for the world, and a win for Russia is a win for oppression.
The end of freedom in Ukraine will mean the extinction of any hope of freedom in Georgia and then Moldova. It will mean the beginning of a new age of intimidation across the whole of Eastern Europe, from the Baltic to the Black Sea.
And since the start of the invasion, 64 Ukrainian children have been killed, hundreds more injured, and over 1.5 million children have been forced to flee. Today, more than 7,000 people were able to leave the besieged city thanks to newly negotiated humanitarian corridors. And a Harvard student from California is helping hundreds of Ukrainian refugees find temporary shelter across the world. After attending a protest in support of Ukraine last month, Avi Schiffman felt it was his moral duty to do something to help. The 19-year-old, who is a talented coder, decided to put his skills to work, and along with the help of his friends, he built a website that matches hosts around the world willing to shelter Ukrainian refugees and refugees that need a place to stay. It's called Ukraine Takes Shelter and operates in 12 languages.
We're really thankful for the real volunteers that are the people hosting their homes for all these refugees. We've heard incredible stories.
On the site, refugees type in their location and the host offers pop up. The listings include the language spoken by the host, information about the space available, and whether pets are allowed. And there are always ways you can help Ukrainian refugees. On our website, we have a list of humanitarian organizations helping those fleeing the violence. Just head to NBCBayArea.com and click on our link in the trending bar. Under fire, the mayor of Antioch took to social media apologizing to his community after being cited for driving under the influence early Saturday morning. Lamar Thorpe apologized and took full responsibility for what happened.
Although I never felt inhibited by the drink I had with my dinner, I'm deeply sorry for the lapse in judgment, and I hope that you can forgive me.
Thorpe says he was pulled over on the way home from having dinner with a friend. The arrest happened around 1:15 Saturday morning on 680 there in Pleasant Hill. He's pledging to learn and grow from that incident. It was an emotional night as family and friends gathered to remember 8-year-old Sophia Mason. The little girl from Hayward was reported missing and later found dead at a home in Merced. As Today in the Bay's Marianne Favreau reports, her family and the community hope the gathering helped everyone start to heal.
Tonight, the focus was not just on remembering Sophia, but making important changes in the future to better protect children.
Her family says Sophia Mason was a bright, vibrant 8-year-old who loved dancing. They called her So-So.
A sweet, wonderful girl. Like, as my sister said, you would never have known outside of this situation if you had met her on the street, that she was going through all that she had. She was so wonderful and so happy and full of joy and promise.
Heavy hearts in Hayward as people gathered to remember the 8-year-old who was found dead in a Merced home. Sophia's mother, Samantha Johnson, is accused of murder, and police are still searching for her boyfriend, Dante Jackson. Tonight, Sophia's young classmates struggling to understand why they can't play with their friend anymore.
She used to play with her.
She always brings joy, and she always was smiling and happy. I just wish I could see her again.
Sophia's family say they reported warning signs of abuse to police and Child Protective Services. Police confirm they received reports of possible abuse, but state agents decided to leave Sophia with her mother.
Sophia was saying that mommy and Dante are hitting me, they're beating me with belt buckles. There were bruises between her legs.
Now Sophia's family is joining forces with the community to make sure other children will be better protected.
We're also here to elevate her case, elevate what happened to her, so that we can make sure that in the future that adults and systems respond to kids' cry for help.
A family shedding tears for their loss, vowing that Sophia's short life will be a catalyst for change. In Hayward, Marianne Favreau, NBC Bay Area News.
Family and volunteers took part in another search for Alexis Gabe. Over the weekend, a group of volunteers met at the streets of Brentwood Mall on Saturday. Gabe was last seen in late January. Her car was found abandoned in Oakley with the keys still in the ignition. Volunteers say just having an extra set of eyes to look for her is helpful.
Anybody can come out and help search. I'm in a wheelchair and I am here. You could be have any other kind of disability. You could have one that's unforeseen, and you can still come out and help.
The search came just 3 days after Gabe turned 24. Today, community members are invited to join members of Alexis's family at the Antioch Oakley Regional Shoreline Park. They'll be holding a vigil for Alexis. They'll be meeting at 6 this evening. And a very important memorial in San Francisco got some TLC over the weekend. More than 100 volunteers showed up to pull out some weeds and clean up the National AIDS Memorial Grove inside of Golden Gate Park. Volunteers say it's important to restore the park to honor loved ones lost from AIDS or HIV.
You know, everything is really planned to make it as beautiful as possible. It's a memorial for a lot of people that come here to honor the people that they've lost.
It was the first cleanup day of the year at the park. Volunteers plan to meet every third Saturday of the month through October. And tomorrow on Today in the Bay, Dr. Monica Gandhi will explain how city health leaders are working to increase the number of HIV screenings after they took a sharp dip amid the pandemic. You can watch that story tomorrow. Make sure you tune in from 4:30 a.m. to 7. We're going to take a live look at the San Francisco skyline, where billions of dollars have been spent to clean up the streets of San Francisco. But some say it's worse than ever, and there are proven fixes that could help transform the city. Episode 4 of our streaming series, Saving San Francisco, comes out Monday. And in an exclusive interview with Mayor London Breed, we ask, what is she doing to move the city forward?
We were in the midst of a global pandemic. Yes, things have gotten worse. And now, as we're living with COVID, you know, we're really taking a hard stance on trying to turn these problems around.
Watch the first 3 episodes right now on your Roku or your other streaming device by downloading the NBC Bay Area app or going to nbcbayarea.com/savingsanfrancisco and see episode 4 on Monday. Really good series there. Well, still to come on Today in the Bay, fighting our climate in crisis. The reason experts now worry that global warming is now happening at a much faster pace than once believed. The consequences we may soon see because of it.
One-800 got junk can bring the springtime anytime.
Oh, yes! We make junk disappear. All you have to do is point.
Call 1-800-GOT-JUNK
or visit 1-800-GOT-JUNK.com.
In these times of uncertainty, there's a promise we can count on.
that together we'll continue to rise to the challenge and find a way forward. Stanford Medicine, made up of Stanford Children's Health, Stanford School of Medicine, and Stanford Healthcare, is working to end this pandemic with vaccines, boosters, and state-of-the-art testing. Responding to uncertainty with an unwavering commitment to our community, we are Stanford Medicine, and we are here for you.
Time and temperature on NBC Bay Area is brought to you by Mancini Sleep World, simply the best place to buy a mattress.
Receive three free gifts with a qualifying mattress purchase now at Mancini Sleep World.
A brand new car loses roughly 50% of its value in the first 3 years. A used car from Shift doesn't. Second grade level arithmetic. Still valuable.
Shift.com. Used cars never felt so new.
No one should have to go to bed hungry or worry about where their next meal is coming from. Not children, not families, elders, or veterans. Not in the richest country in the world. Not in the richest region in America. That's why Loaves and Fishes Family Kitchen has been serving the Bay Area for 41 years. You don't have to meet any criteria to get a free meal. Everyone is welcome. No questions asked. Visit loavesfishes.org to get involved.
1-800-GOT-JUNK can bring the springtime anytime.
Oh. Yes! We make junk disappear. All you have to do is point.
Call 1-800-GOT-JUNK
or visit 1-800-GOT-JUNK.com.
Welcome back. It's 7:41. You're watching Today in the Bay. Turning to our climate in crisis, scientists say the North and South Poles are seeing freakish heat waves. Weather stations in Antarctica shattered records ahead of the weekend. The 2-mile-high Concordia station measured 10 degrees, which is about 70 degrees warmer than average. In the Arctic, it was about 50 degrees warmer than average. Yesterday, near or at the melting point, this is extremely rare because Antarctica is approaching fall as the Arctic approaches summer. To have both poles melting at the same time is unprecedented. Scary stuff there. Now taking a live look outside San Jose. Beautiful morning. Not too much of a warming trend here, but the day is shaping up to be a nice one. Meteorologist here has a look at our forecast.
Yeah, Sierra, and we will be cool today, but then as we head in towards the week, things are expected to also warm up here in the Bay Area. And take a live look right now at the Bay Bridge Toll Plaza, span, right? This is as you get on the bridge. It is going to be a nice sunny day. You could see satellite radar now much calmer than that green that we saw, although it was a welcome sight in the Bay Area. Current temperatures, as you head out the door, that system was colder, so we're going to see the winds pick up, but also the temps are running a few degrees cooler right now. Look at Dublin, 39 degrees, Concord, 39, up through Santa Rosa, 41. And here's a closer look at the 24-hour temperature change. So we're about 11 degrees colder in Concord and Livermore compared to the past 24 hours. Now, as far as your headlines, we are going to be breezy and dry today. But yes, spring officially begins at 8:33. Then we've got warming ahead, and that could mean temperatures of 15 to 25 degrees above average, which could set new records here in the Bay Area. So let's take you through your hour by hour temperatures, because notice the timestamp right up there by about 10:30. We do warm up into the 50s. And then if I fast forward this to about 12 o'clock, we're talking upper 50s, low 60s in the forecast. And then by about 4:30, we do only top out in the mid 60s today. So no 70s on the map, but the winds are going to pick up 15, 20 plus mile per hour winds till about 7 o'clock. Then the winds begin to diminish even down through the south, but you can see here right around 3 o'clock, 19 mile per hour winds in San Jose, down through Ben Lomond, the Santa Cruz Mountain area. You can expect that as well. Much calmer winds heading into Monday. Now, I do, of course, want to talk about the vernal equinox at 8:33. We're approaching that in about 45 minutes. The Earth is perpendicular to the sun's rays on spring equinox. That's a 23.5 tilt of Earth, which actually creates our seasons as Earth revolves around the sun. And what that means for us is good. It's daylight increasing as the sun sets later. So it won't look as dark outside at, you know, the 5-6 o'clock hour. Now, as far as the countdown to the warm-up goes, we've got this building high pressure, and that's going to be much warmer heading into Monday and Wednesday, and any chance of rain is going to stay to our north. So let's get to that 7-day forecast and get you prepared for the week ahead. We had 50s topping out yesterday. Today we're going to top out in the 60s. It'll be a little breezy. Look at Monday and Tuesday. The temperature goes from 60s to upper 70s in San Francisco, and then we keep the breezy dry hills until Wednesday. The temperatures begin to cool down, but it's those 80s and even the 70s in San Francisco. That could bring us near record highs, especially into Tuesday and Wednesday, Sierra. So it's going to be quite an interesting week. But notice, no more rain, at least not for the next 7 days ahead.
I love to hear it. Well, we'll have much more ahead on Today in the Bay. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Build your Ford from the ground up. Want it in a regular cab, super cab, or super crew? You got it. In an F-150 built your way. And now get an extra $1,000 bonus cash on top of all public offers. All on a Ford built for you, by you. Order today.
Something that's important to me is stability, and VTA has been able to provide that for me and my family. I started out as a bus operator, and with the opportunities VTA provided, I was able to take advantage of the Leadership Academy and the Supervisor Home Study. That's how I became a supervisor. My kids love the fact that I am a supervisor, and they love to call me the boss. I love my job because of the opportunities that I've been granted, and I have VTA to thank for.
Fresh out of Papa Murphy's kitchen, the Buffalo Ranch Chicken Pizza.
Actually, it's fresh out of my oven.
Dad, it's just an expression.
Grilled chicken, crunchy bacon, covered in creamy buffalo sauce. Now that is an expression.
Change the way you pizza.
Why are my shirts so wrinkled and smell like mildew?
Keep forgetting to replace that broken appliance? Let Airport Home Appliance get you off the hook during their spring savings event with same-day or free next-day delivery on select in-stock appliances. Plus, spring into action with up to 35% off appliances and 0% financing for up to 24 months at Airport Home Appliance. Unbeatable price, selection, and people.
Build your Ford from the ground up. Want it in a regular cab, super cab, or super crew? You got it. In an F-150 built your way. And now get an extra $1,000 bonus cash on top of all public offers. All on a Ford built for you, by you. Order today.
Well, it's bad news for rapper Ye, formerly known as Kanye West. The award-winning rapper is being cut from the Grammys. Despite being nominated for 5 awards, West was supposed to perform, but his recent post attacking Grammy host Trevor Noah raised concerns that things may get heated on music's biggest night. The comedian recently criticized West's behavior on an episode of The Daily Show. In a developing story, 6 people are recovering from injuries this morning after an L.A. Sheriff's Department helicopter crash. Now, it happened in the Angeles Forest near Azusa as the chopper was responding to a service call. At least 2 of the victims were airlifted to the hospital. Others suffered less serious injuries, according to a doctor who was on board for a ride-along. 5 of the crash victims were deputies. The L.A. County Sheriff says he is thankful everyone made it out without critical injuries. Meantime, a former Apple employee is accused of taking millions of dollars from the company. Federal prosecutors say he worked for the tech company for 10 years. They say he exploited his position in the global service supply chain department to accept illegal payments, stealing equipment, and laundering money. Now he's being charged with defrauding Apple out of $10 million. He's set to appear in court on Thursday. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi was in Florida Saturday. During her visit, she talked about the impact of the new infrastructure law. Florida is set to receive $19 billion to help improve infrastructure there. Pelosi and Florida leaders held a press conference at the George Bush Boulevard Bridge, which has been stuck open for weeks. The House Speaker talked about how the law won't just fix bad roads and bridges, but will try to undo some of the inequity caused by infrastructure in the past.
This legislation is building infrastructure with equity and with justice to erase past dividing of community by building a highway through a neighborhood. This instead reverses that, and to do so with environmental justice so that everyone can be healthier because of what we do.
The speaker also emphasized the importance of maintaining infrastructure, saying, quote, the most expensive maintenance is no maintenance at all. And people doing good things for others. That is what our Bay Area Proud series is all about. What's even better is these good news stories don't end when we share them. Today in the Bay's Garvin Thomas has an update for us about what some people he has introduced us to what they're doing now.
In 2018, we shared the wonderful story of Siri Chattopalli and how this young woman living with autism and her family saw her life blossom through the simple act of making jewelry. They even started a company, Designs by Siri, to sell her work, as well as by others living with autism. Well, since then, Siri's parents have delved into so many other types of therapy, from exercise to dance to horseback riding, all producing amazing results. And it has now all caught the attention of a documentary filmmaker specializing in stories about empowering women, who is now editing her latest work called My Name is Siri.
Oh, here, KNTV Nina.
In 2018, we also shared the story of Stephanie Trung. A former NBC Bay Area reporter, Stephanie had turned her own journey with cancer into a platform to provide the kind of clear-eyed and comforting information a person diagnosed with cancer is desperately in need of. Stephanie's platform, now called The Patient Story, is now receiving 100,000 visitors a month.
Well, what I think is important to
most of them, patients just diagnosed with cancer, can hear stories of those who have just been down the very same path, while also empowering patients with the latest information about treatments to help them guide their care.
As the numbers climb, what's the most meaningful is that there's all this feedback coming back saying, I was looking for this. I wasn't finding it anywhere. Thank you.
She can say hi.
Finally, in October, we shared the story of Daniel Siever. Daniel and his two golden retrievers, Emerson and Cooper, had been on the road for close to a decade, providing comfort to victims of disaster, both natural and man-made. The VTA shooting in San Jose is what brought them to the Bay Area. Daniel tells us, though, that one of his dogs, Emerson, died this past December, and he wasn't sure what he was going to do, but has recently decided that he and Cooper will hit the road once again. Inspired by what's been happening in Ukraine, Daniel says the world still needs their special service.
Next, a quick look at the top stories, including the new mask guidance for kids in the East Bay, when and where they'll no longer be required to wear masks.
Who's ready for Sunday fun day? Live look right now at the Bay Bridge Span. It's going to be a stunning day, breezy winds, and what to expect this upcoming work week. Details coming up. Stay with us.
On the next episode of Saving San Francisco.
You step over shit. You step over garbage, and the main thing, you step over our people.
How does a city with a $12 billion budget look this way?
Dealing with each of the people that are struggling requires a lot of work.
There are proven fixes.
It was resoundingly successful.
So why is the city still suffering?
Join us as we search for solutions to move San Francisco forward. Saving San Francisco, episode 4, streams Monday.
I'm very, very nervous.
No one sings their face off like you, my friend.
An audience with Adele, tonight on NBC.
Is your state the best? It's time to prove it.
American Song Contest.
It's state versus state, and only one can win. So, America, which state will you be voting for? American Song Contest premieres live Monday on NBC.
The Ford Store Morgan Hill would like to thank you for making us the number one retail volume Ford dealer in the entire Bay Area for another year. Come experience our low bottom line sale prices clearly marked in all new and pre-owned vehicles window. We still never price our vehicles with additional dealer markup. Plus, get 0% financing on new trucks and SUVs. Plus, new vehicle truckloads are being delivered weekly. But if we don't have exactly what you're looking for, we can custom order for you. Only at the Ford Store Morgan Hill.
Recognized as a top national preschool program for academic achievement, Cadango's preschool programs build a love of learning, helping grow children who are confident, capable, and ready for kindergarten. Our highly qualified and passionate teachers provide young children with safe, healthy, and nurturing environments and relationships so that each child has the social, emotional, and academic skills needed to learn and grow. Be kindergarten ready. Enroll today at cadango.org.
Wow!
Legoland!
We made it!
It's amazing.
Special! Special! Special!
Wait, why are we leaving?
Emmett's flying adventure ride?
Hold on!
this is gonna get bumpy.
The Lego Movie World, now open at Legoland California Resort.
I love your hair, man.
Welcome back. Here's a quick look at the top stories we're following, including the latest out of Ukraine. New this morning, we are learning that President Zelensky has extended martial law for an extra 30 days. We are also learning that Russia has turned to a strategy of attrition. Defense experts say Russia's indiscriminate use of firepower will cause more civilian deaths and worsen the humanitarian crisis. On Saturday, Russia confirmed the launch of a hypersonic missile to destroy a warehouse filled with ammunition right outside of the city of Kyiv. This weapon has the ability to fly 10 times the speed of sound, and they are extremely difficult to stop. Since the start of the invasion, 64 Ukrainian children have been killed, hundreds more injured, and over 1.5 million children have been forced to flee. Today, more than 7,000 people were able to leave the besieged cities thanks to newly negotiated humanitarian corridors. An emotional remembrance in Hayward was held for 8-year-old Sophia Mason. Sophia was found dead last week in Merced after being reported missing by her family. Sophia's mother, Samantha Johnson, is accused of murdering her, and police are still searching for her boyfriend, Dante Jackson. Sophia's family says they reported warning signs and abuse to police, as well as Child Protective Services. Police confirmed they received reports about potential abuse, but state agents decided to leave Sophia with her mother. Now Sophia's family is joining forces with community members to make sure other children are better protected in the future so tragedies like this never happen. And moving you forward this morning, starting tomorrow, students within the Oakland Unified School District will now be able to ditch masks while in outdoor settings. The new mask guidance applies to all students, staff, volunteers, and visitors. Masks indoors are still required. That guidance will be reviewed again come April 15th. And V&A has one final check at the potentially beautiful forecast.
Yeah, you know, I got to look at your headlines. If you look outside right now, you're going to notice sunshine and not a lot of rain. That's because that system has made its exit, and here's what to expect. A quick check of your headlines once again. Breezy and dry Sunday. Remember, spring officially starts at 8:33 this morning. And then looking ahead, warmer temperatures, 15 to 25 degrees potentially above average, could mean nearing new record highs during the middle of the week. So we're going to go from chilly temps Saturday to mild temps today, and then all of a sudden, and we're going to bump up into the mid-70s in San Francisco by Tuesday. Notice near record high, 75 degrees. Breezy hills on Wednesday, which is always a concern because it is still very dry. We need a ton of rain. We're still in a drought. And then spring sunshine by Thursday. But it's going to feel a little more like spring on Monday than it is on Tuesday and Wednesday, because Tuesday and Wednesday is going to be a preview of summer. We're talking mid-80s for inland areas. Again, watching out for breezy dry hills heading into Wednesday. But enjoy your Sunday funday. Have a lovely day.
All right, thank you so much for making us a part of your morning. We'll have more local news for you tonight at 5, 6, and 11 this evening, as well as all day on NBCBayArea.com. Have a great, beautiful Sunday morning.